Over the past few days, I have counted at least 15 news articles that have said the exact same thing. Vegans and vegetarians had higher risk of stroke, but it's okay because their risk of heart disease is lower. That's not actually true. Their overall mortality did not change. They just died from their brain exploding instead of their heart stopping. There are several flaws with this study. One is that we are using the term meat eater, when in reality, meat eaters consume the majority of their calories from plants. People say Americans are sucking down meat like nobody's business, but reality is that Americans consume over 70% of their calories from plant foods. Does a cheeseburger or a hot dog really have the majority of its calories from the meat? Or are there so many fillers and processed junk plant foods in that product that we are consuming? We also have to consider that the majority of meat consumed in the United States is low quality, conventionally raised crap. This ties into pescatarians having the best life expectancy as found in this study. Most fish is of far higher quality than the beef, pork, and chicken that people are eating, and if we were to consume wild quality meats, pasture-raised, grass-fed, the results of the study would have been drastically different. The main issue with this study, which applies to just about every single nutritional study there is that the relative risk is inconsiderable. Relative risk is used to measure the change in disease rates according to the study. And the real purpose of relative risk is, do we need to conduct further research? Because if the number is high enough, that means, okay, there is something here, but by no means should this relative risk number be thrown into a news article saying that vegans and vegetarians have a 20% higher risk of stroke. That's not what the number actually means. So these news publishers dig the study out of the garbage bin and use it to fearmonger the population and fit certain agendas. I would like to disregard this study and all of these nonsense news articles, but this study is a lot different from others in the sense that it did not change the variables. They didn't plug in certain algorithms and formulas to manipulate the data. They just looked at statistics. Usually, they're trying to account for smoking, lack of exercise, other factors in the lifestyle. This was hard statistics, and there is a pattern of vegans and vegetarians having a higher risk of stroke and lower heart disease rates. But we want an explanation. Many of these articles speculated cholesterol or nutrient deficiencies. Fortunately for you boys and girls, Frankie Boy has discovered the mechanism that causes vegans to have a stroke. And there's two parts to this. Vitamin B12 deficiency causing a high homocysteine level in the blood, in addition to a high omega-6 fatty acid linoleic acid consumption. Homocysteine is an amino acid that occurs in the blood. It is normally converted into methionine, requiring a lot of nutrients that are only found in animal foods. Even when vegans supplement vitamin B12, they still exhibit high homocysteine levels because they are not converting it properly. High homocysteine contributes to arterial damage and blood clots. This is probably the most dangerous aspect of a vegan diet, and it's unusual how every single vegan has high blood levels of homocysteine but doesn't talk about it. Linoleic acid is an omega-6 fatty acid that occurs in large amounts in vegetable seed oils. As many vegans are afraid of fat and don't consume large amounts of them, this is a lesser issue compared to homocysteine, but isn't something that should be ignored. However, it is safe to say that a high homocysteine level can lead to a stroke on its own. When you consume large amounts of linoleic acid, the plant form of omega-6 fats, the fats in your body actually change their composition to this fatty acid. all of the triglycerides, the lipids, including cholesterol. You are what you eat. Your body doesn't actually recognize linoleic acid when it exceeds a certain percentage in the tissue. It starts producing inflammatory compounds to get rid of it. This is because linoleic acid never existed in high amounts in our diets until we started consuming soybean oil, canola oil, peanut oil, and the many plant-based processed foods that contain large amounts of vegetable seed oils. Imagine your body not recognizing a cell, attacking it, and the cell becoming inflamed. This is a very simple explanation of how linoleic acid actually causes heart disease. So you have the increased oxidative stress and arterial damage from high homocysteine. Imagine just a bunch of amino acids just wreaking havoc, going crazy in your blood vessels. There's so much of them that your body is trying to get rid of them, and dealing with that results in a lot of cell death that is not controlled because your body simply can't handle high homocysteine levels. Then you have more oxidative stress and arterial damage from omega-6 linoleic acid. Not only is your body attacking the cholesterol cells that are composed of linoleic acid, which are actually trying to heal tissue, these omega-6 fats are very prone to oxidation. It's pretty easy to see how a diet low in vitamin B12 and high in omega-6 is an early way to the grave. Now, these news articles did say that eliminating meat will reduce your risk of heart disease. But as we said earlier, these people are consuming low quality conventionally raised meat. Guess what happens when you feed pigs and chickens soybean and corn? Their fatty acid profile turns into linoleic acid. So when you eat those pork ribs or chicken thighs, you are essentially eating the vegetable seed oils, the processed foods that have been poisoning Americans for dozens of years. I actually brought this up several months ago in a video titled, "A Vegan Diet Will Give You a Stroke." But now that this news article came out, it seems like a good opportunity to address this again and see if the knowledge goes mainstream. I don't think anyone has connected the dots on high homocysteine and high linoleic acid consumption leading to stroke. So I'll link that video at the end here if you want to understand more about the science behind what is actually going on in the body. If the understanding of this becomes mainstream, it would deal a devastating blow to the vegan diet. You can replicate this in controlled studies incredibly easily. It would become clear that we need to consume animal foods and that vitamin B12 supplements and eating some dirt on your vegetables is not adequate. I don't think there is a better opportunity than this. With how popular this has been in the media, even my parents are talking about this, and I think just about everyone else is as well. I hope you guys can share my video and spread the understanding of why this is happening. Thank you guys for joining me. If you could please hit the like button and subscribe, as well as hit that bell icon. If you guys would like to support me further, definitely check out Frankie's Free Range Meat. If you guys would also like to check out Frankie's Naturals, minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products, you can also reach out to me, frankatufano@gmail.com, for one-on-one fitness and health consultations. Thanks again for joining me, guys, and enjoy the rest of your weekend.